Okay, so I have my my wet locks right after I wash them. I covered the countertop with overlapping plastic and I made my dye stocks. And I'm wearing my rubber gloves because I always get my hands stained. And when you're trying to figure out what colors to use for your locks, the best thing to do is use a color wheel, and then you'll see what colors will turn into other colors. For example, you know, if you put a red down here and then you put a yellow up here, you know, you're going to get orange at that that line between the two. And if you want brown, then you'll look at colors that mix together to make brown. So just kind of plan out your colors, look at some colorways online for some color ideas and see what might be kind of neat. Okay, so I'm starting with a dye stock solution. With this particular one, I'm just going to use red, yellow, and blue. So I'm going to do the darker colors at the end because I think visually, I think it just looks better with it dark on the end. And I usually make a pretty strong solution because I like my colors pretty saturated. So, okay, so then I'm going to just squirt it onto the fiber and kind of smush it in. And I have a paper towel handy because you want to sop up some of those marks there, because when you steam it, those may go up into the top. Now you can either use a straight line of color, or you can kind of blend it up into the fiber and get some more interesting blends of color. I'll do a little bit of that. And you just gently want to smoosh down. You see the bottom side is saturated, so you want to make sure that the color goes all the way through. All right, then I'm going to do my red. And then when it hits some of the blue, it's gonna turn purple. Smoosh that in. So you'll get some pretty cool variations of the color as it's going up the lock. I'm just gonna look to make sure all the color is saturated through there. Okay, I'm going to get my yellow ready and put the yellow on. Okay, I've got the yellow ready and put the yellow on. And that's going to be my last color. So I'm just going to saturate the rest of the fiber with that. And I'm going to put a little bit of it down into the red because I want it to turn orange down in that section there. Make sure you get all of that saturated. There we go. I'm going to turn it over and see. It looks like it's pretty much there. Okay, and I'm going to sop up the rest of the dye that's on the plastic. Okay. And getting a little leakage down here. Okay, and then we're going to wrap it up long ways. All right, and then we're going to go from light to dark because we don't want the dark seeping into the light section. All righty, and there is our little packet ready to go into the steamer.